Right, back on another job, me and Dave again.
Yeah, we're in WA7, Runcorn,
yeah.
Preston Brook, I think it is.
You want to see the view they got in their back garden?
We've got a black manhole.
Over here.
Leading out. It's already, you can see evidence of roots there at the top, but we'll locate the outlet and we'll get it unblocked and we'll have a look.
So she's obviously had problems when flushing toilets and sinks and stuff. And the other day seeing like a milky colour, she said.
Yeah.
Cut off on this manhole.
Right, so it's going that way, I think. So we must have.
Will it go?
So that back to the house. And that
can
one.
You feel the channels on it?
Yeah.
Which way do you think it's going?
Yeah, it's going. Starting to anyway.
Trying.
Yeah, so it's got to go that way. That's the way we're going to go. So it is heading towards those.
Can I see to see? She's had an extension on.
Yeah.
So if it is going that way.
Let's give it another poke. I can't feel any more.
Do you want me to have a feel or?
Yeah. You can do. I can't feel any more outlets other than.
Oh, Dave, look.
There we go. Lovely. So there's obviously an issue going that way.
Just on the outlet.
And there's still an issue. By the looks of it, no.
There's roots around.
There's roots. There's nothing down there.
That right there is going to get us a lot of views.
The sweet sound of success. So what we're going to do...
Do you know what it could be? She's flushing her loo here, slapping on the side,
yeah,
and it's just catching.
And it's hitting. I've noticed that on a couple of jobs because you've got...
These manholes are not the best.
...potential for things to be stuck, and you've almost got a 90 degree turn there. So things do get stuck around. And look, when you look, this is proud. And it's
See all this here? Yeah. Catches on here on the side.
But what we'll do, we'll get the camera out because they've requested us to have a look.
Yeah.
And we'll see if there's anything. I don't think there's anything there. I think that's what we
I think that's the problem there.
The problem. So if you just leave that on it.
Yeah.
The fact that it was all stuck around the end there.
Dave, you're too quick. I've not done this yet.
I've heard that before.
Yeah, you can kind of see here. You haven't done the benching properly.
Yeah.
There's gaps where the roots coming through.
Yeah, but I'm really concerned about how proud that pipe's sitting. It's just gonna...
That's just the way these are, but they're not... These are just the cheap, nasty...
But even
now,
it could have been cut back a little bit. We were slapping against there, it's getting wedged in that corner there. So let's see, we'll put the camera through anyway.
Yeah, that's the main problem. As you know, small manholes like here, slapping the side, and you've got a big lip there. So obviously all your tissue paper catches on. Which are not ideal.
It's strange how them roots are just there.
And haven't done the benching properly, that's why.
No, that's it, look.
Half a job.
Nice.
Anyway, come down. It's very nice.
We'll have to try and get...
For that.
It's lovely, isn't it?
Beautiful.
We're going to have to try and get a soapy bucket. Hopefully we can tap somewhere, even that we'll use from the van, and give that a right...
Get a bucket
right
full, yeah.
...in a bit.
About an hour later, we'll come back a bit in about an hour for when this camera loads.
One hour later,
getting distracted.
My favourite's Patrick Starfish, anyway. He's brilliant. Guys, let's get that a bit of a wipe. Okay, so
slipping in.
Well, obviously we know the issue is from this point on. And you look.
It was just on the outlet, man.
Just the outlet. Let's just go. Just
check the runs.
Give it a good run. This all looks pretty good, Nick. Yeah, well, we do know.
It's not there.
It's this. Roots. And the drop drain.
Is it dropped?
Yeah, look. See that yellow at the bottom?
Oh yeah.
Partly dropped. Okay, now, I do think it was still this that was the issue, but...
Cause a problem, that could also be a further problem. How long's that? 4, 3?
3 metres, so it might have been that. Just that little bit of foot pressure.
Here?
Yeah. I'll just see if I can get past it. Yeah. Okay, so, let's just...
up to a manhole, everything looks fine.
That's the manhole, which is around that, the other side of that building.
So, I think one of them. There's two issues there. So what we'll do, I'll make a note of the distance.
It's about 3 metres it was the roots, bang on three.
See the issue it's causing here? Because where
that should give you a bit of view and bump. Where it's just pooling there.
Yeah, and it's...
It's cleared a bit there now.
Yeah, so...
And then that's where it's still off.
We're at exactly 3 metre point there, so I'll just take a photograph.
Justin's just gone for the trip down.
I do apologise everyone for dropping you in the drain.
Well, you know.
Back at it again, me and Dave in CH45. So, here's Dave.
Hi, we're in Wallasey.
Wallasey, yeah.
The soil are backing up and the drain further back. But we've obviously down here, we've got an access point. We're having trouble getting that up, so we're going to go through the access point on the soil stack and see if we can blast it from there.
Yeah, as these are always a bugger to get up these, like modernised, the screws always go solid on side. This here is a gully, that's just, I believe, running into that. This here, obviously, rammed, that's full. So Dave's going to take that off, so I thought we'd better do a GoPro video on it. And the customer's also mentioned that when he's using his dishwasher, when this fills that up, this tends to back up every so often. So, obviously, Dave wants to do the most fun for yous and get a little bit of an explosion off this, don't you, Dave?
I don't think we'll get much off that.
No. I say these are the bugger. Yeah, obviously we could break into that, but if we can avoid it, say it's making a mess or making it unsafe for the customer or anybody else.
We've got this option. If we didn't have this option, we'd probably have to go through that.
Yeah.
It won't be much, if anything, because it's a downstairs loop.
No. You might get a bit of a gush, it's a bit of
it was slowly.
I was fooled. Hang on a minute.
No, it's
it felt rammed.
No. Oh, that's... No, it's down there, the issue.
Yeah, it's in right there.
That's clear. Beautiful. That's weird. That's weird, though. Yeah, clear. Right, here's coming some. There we go. Anyway, that's it for the video.
Yeah, on to the next one.
On to the next one.
Debris obviously falls down there, and then you've got to get a jetting team in to come and remove that debris.
And we have to dig down, take the shaft completely out to get them clean. It's a big job.
In fact, dig round, take all the sections off, dig them right back to the top, clean them out.
I'm Nigel at Drainfast. And I'm the R&D director. The muck stopper range includes a couple of different options at the minute. One to cover the 450 chambers, and they're aimed to collect the dirt and stop it from getting to the bottom of the chamber and aid easy clearance of 450 chambers and cut down on wasted time and money. We've been working on the muck stopper range for the last 2.5 years now. It's been born out from customer feedback and spotting the problem on sites. And we think we've come up with a product now which will be able to retrofit any make of the 450 range.
The Muckstopper ISC products feature brushes around the edge which allow water to pass through while capturing any dirt and debris that falls in. The brushes also allow enough tolerance to help the products fit in all major drainage brands of inspection chambers. The durable polypropylene bucket captures all dirt and debris that enters the inspection chamber. The Muckstopper poles come as a set of 4 heavy-duty 1-metre poles which screw together with a specially designed hook, making it easy to scrape debris off the brushes and retrieve the Muckstopper for emptying.
The Muckstopper IC range comes in multiple sizes from 300, 450, 500 and 600.
It's simple, it's easy to use, it's quite compact, they're quite easy to put in. It doesn't take a genius to work out how to use it.
Seam hard wearing and good, they're flexible enough to go in.
Saves time, having to clean them out, you put that in, saves a lot of mess. It's just a lot easier for people to use.
Obviously the solution of this product is you're creating a stopper there that catches all that debris and enables our guys to then remove that and not need to bring in anyone else.
Obviously they're easy to put in, very easy to install. They look like they're going to be very easy to take out depending on how much muck's got down there, but usually it's only a barrel full, but you still can't get down to it, and that muck stopper should lift it out with a bit of luck. Looks well designed.